I'm so dedicated to my destination. I'ma get it how I live it with no hesitation. See me making moves, and all this training proves that I'm possible.
Welcome to the MLXT YouTube channel. This is Micah Lancaster, and of course, we are in the series of how to train beginners, grades 1 through 4, or just simply the beginners of the game. And we're gonna do this one dealing with our med grip ball. Now, right now, I'm gonna deal with medicine balls. Now, these are 2 pounds each, and really, this is something that a young player can handle. And we're gonna teach the principles of ball handling, but without actually having a ball. See, sometimes the actual action we're trying to teach is the biggest distraction. Why? Because not every player can simply dribble that well. They slap at the ball and they don't have the mechanics. And so by dribbling basketballs or grip balls in the same way, we're gonna start simulating those mechanics. And so right now, if I'm in a nice wide stance and I pound those medicine balls down, now I'm simulating that actual dribble. And so I was able to load my elbows up the top, I'm able to drive them down, I'm able to pick them up fluidly, and so now I'm actually getting my shoulders in that stance as well. And so I'm actually teaching stance and I'm teaching mechanics. And so if a player is able to do that repeatedly, so they have the ability to really drive the medicine balls up and down, they're actually able to learn the mechanics of a dribble. But go ahead and take a look at this so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. One of the problems that many kids have is they learn how to dribble with their forearms. Their elbow stays down and they simply learn how to dribble this way instead of actually getting their elbow to engage and find power. And so a lot of times we have to train players how to get their elbow involved rather than always dribbling this way. One will let them gain success early, but this one's not gonna carry over into the game as greatly later. This way is gonna be harder in the beginning, but will actually give us results when we need them. And so we wanna start training the elbow as quickly as we can. Now, to do this, we're still working on a form of mechanics. I don't need a basketball. So we're gonna use 2 of our medicine balls. Now, if you don't have these medicine balls, then find anything that you can grip and throw to the floor that will not bounce. And so we wanna put the focus on mechanics, we don't wanna put the focus on the dribble. And so I'm on my grip mat as if I'm dribbling, so I'm on the outside edges. I can now pull those medicine balls up and I'm pushing them to the floor. Now notice when I did that, they went straight down and they stayed there, and then I just simply drop my hips to grab them. And so the bonus is you're working on your stance, you're working on your ability to drop your shoulders, drop your hips, pick them back up, and then drive the elbows again. And so if I'm spending my time working on these dribbles, I'm grabbing them as quickly as I can, I'm releasing them, but now my elbows are driving the balls down just as if I'm dribbling, and I'm working on all those components. And so this is one of those beginning tactics that you can do to train your body how to dribble more appropriately. And if you really think about it, we'll start building into a 2-ball dribble later on. So even if you're a kid who can't dribble 2 basketballs yet, not only are you working on the mechanics of one hand, but you're also preparing yourself to really progress in a 2-ball dribbling later. And so what I want you to do is really focus on repping out about 10 as quickly as you can. And so I drive the elbows up, pick them up, rise my levels, focus on power and dropping your hips. And so you have a lot of components. Do those as hard and aggressive and as quickly as you can. And then you'd rest for a few seconds and then just simply repeat it. And so that's gonna be a ball handling series that's gonna equip your body. Now this is 2 pounds. And so you can start building some really key components to your hand strength, your body strength, your arm strength, and of course, if you need to replace this with anything such as a bag of sand, whatever you can even think of in order to do this, that's fine. Just make sure it's not gonna bounce. It's in a controlled environment, because bottom line is we need to train our elbows and our body, the mechanics for our ball handling later. And that's a phenomenal example of how we can start teaching the mechanics of ball handling without ever dribbling a basketball. It gets us the ability to load our elbows. It gives us the ability to drive the elbows down. It teaches our body those low stances. It teaches dribble placement in front of our body rather than dribbling on the sides of our feet. And so through this process, you're really learning everything that you'll need to learn for ball handling to make sure that we actually have those mechanics with our elbows, we have the follow through, we have the body position, and we have the stance. See, a lot of times, it's the simulations of movement that's gonna make the biggest difference. So when we're teaching young players how to dribble, don't always put a basketball in their hands. Find something that they can throw down and pick up. Even if you don't have medicine balls, find something that can simply be placed down, because now you have the ability to simulate those things for them, strengthen their hands in the process, and essentially teach them how to dribble the basketball through that action. Of course, if you like content like this and you want to see more, make sure that you join us next week by making sure that you're subscribed. And always, we appreciate your engagement. Like and comment on these videos and ring the notification bell so you don't miss next week's beginner program as we take a look at another topic that you can do with beginners in grades 1 through 4. I'll see you guys next week.